Phase 1. Two rhesus monkeys were instrumented for EKG and arterial pressure.
And tracheotomized.
Metal handles on each calvarium ensured manipulation of the head.
Nembutal anesthesia.
The cervixes were surgically transected along the C4-5 cervical line. Division of spinal cords completed, life was mechanically supported. Infusion of catecholamine maintained mean arterial pressure at 10 cm. Carotid jugular vascular loops provided cerebral hemoglobin. Phase 2. At 4.0 hours, the cephalons awakened, demonstrating persistent awareness. Subjects were capable of vocalizing, tracking with wide eyes, and biting, also if given the chance. EEG recorded these established characteristics of an awake pattern. Phase 3. Within the sleep of dreams once more, cephalons were exchanged, sutured to the other's waiting host.
A new beginning.
Carotid arteries and jugular veins were anastomosed by microsurgery. And then? Past transplantation. 0.8. And then, like dawn or consciousness breaking, the cephalons in tandem began awakening.
Dream on, their recipient bodies.
Normal cranial function was noted, displaying characteristic monkey responses. Alert eyes, teeth that bite.
Injected dye.
Instruments translated what sense recorded over 24 mortal hours.
Common earthly revolution.
Until arterial and venous pressures were aborted, implications for higher primates still withstanding, awaiting evolution in primate understanding.